I think the last speaker, Sami, has somehow diverted my attention elsewhere. I was going to intervene with, seriously, I'm always nervous in a crowd. I didn't realize because I grew up very close to the Mercato and used to hang out near my father's store. But even with that kind of background, I still always felt nervous in a crowd. And I realized that the reason was mostly because I rarely belong in a crowd. And I have felt less belonging in this crowd the last 2 days. And there was also some puzzling issue that was recurring in my head, which is how a university or a school that's whose interest is in economics and political science, and a foundation or a philanthropic foundation whose most driving belief is about competition and compassion and freedom and responsibility can be associated with something that is considered most immoral in most people's societies as urbanism. Because that's where most evil, including a sad event that transpired 29 years ago on this day that involves a grief in the family of the foundation, happened on November 30. By the invitation of Anna, I had looked it up in the Wikipedia edition saying, it must be you are involved in this for a composition of a social construct on what urbanism is. And probably the foundation is on a crusade of avoiding evils that brew in urban centers from the immorality of society. But like Astrid said, Addis is, compared to Lagos, it's much, much smaller, and there's not much money here. So you must really be concerned about what evil is going to brew out of Addis soon. Well, if we're going to follow the path of development that Sami or the people that were present at Lagar last week are proposing, the quick and posh way of urbanizing Addis, believe me, there's more evil coming. But there are other ways of doing this. Because from I'm a very assuming, opinionated person. And you should hear me when I speak in Amharic, because this is imposed upon me that I should speak on an imperial language with whom most Pan-Africans agree. But
where's the
thing is, let me tell you, the sinister motive of bringing money into the poor neighborhoods of Africa, I believe, is to create a secondary or tertiary capital, which would, of course, leverage the existing highly accumulated capital that you already have in Europe and America. And although labor can fend for itself without capital, we all know that capital cannot fend for itself without people or labor. So, although at the expense of my minutes, I need to say this, if you want to make money out of the poor, you need the leverage of the government, definitely. Without the leverage of the government, you can't do that. To do that legally, and for, as Tao said, to maintain certainty in policy and legislation, and for that to last longer than between two elections, you need to ground it into the productivity of the people who you wish to cram into high-rise buildings. We have to start from the social fabric that we have already, call it blight or slums, or my neighborhood, it doesn't matter. But there are people who are making a living there, and although they live in a most blighted environment, they're not poor. They're very smart, they have political muscle, and some of them, like me, have money. So if you aggregate that and come up with a solution that would sustainably make your capital labor and capitalize our labor, then that would avoid evil. Avoid evil, and it will avoid you. That's my saying.
Right. Thank you for that.